Philippine retail gaming provider DigiPlus refutes a report that says it will restart its $500 million casino project in Boracay Island. That story and more from Denise Insay. Hi, Denise.
Hi, Stanley. Now, the listed company says it has no imminent plans to pursue the development of its 24-hectare property on the island into an integrated casino project. DigiPlus asserts it remains focused on growing its digital entertainment segment, which has become its core business since 2022. The news article in question cited its founder, Bacolod City Mayor Albi Benitez, as the source of information. But DigiPlus, formerly known as Leisure and Resorts World Corporation, clarified Benitez has stepped down from the board of directors since 2021.
A Philippine meat importer urges government to consider keeping the lower tariffs on imported meat and other food products to bring down prices. This as Executive Order No. 10, which granted the lower duties, will expire by the end of the year. According to Jess Cham of the Meat Importers and Traders Association, protecting local hog and poultry farmers through high tariffs has not resulted in lower prices for consumers. Now, to help the local industry weather the impact of competition from imports, Cham says the government should consider allocating funds to support local hog and poultry farmers.
They have to compete, right? The government will have to realign its budget. I'm sure there are a lot of fat that is stored somewhere in the government budget. They have to realign it and to give it then bring it over to support the producers. It's a long time coming. It's overdue. They should bite the bullet. What's to guarantee that if we bring the tariff back up, then the local prices are going to go even higher? That's a big concern.
Russian President Vladimir Putin is in China to meet his good friend Xi Jinping in what is seen as a show of the two countries' no-limits partnership. Now, Putin's first official trip outside the former Soviet Union this 2023 is to show support for China's trillion-dollar Belt and Road Initiative, which is marking its 10th year. Moscow has cemented its energy ties with Beijing since the start of its invasion of Ukraine in a sign of their fledgling economic cooperation. Putin has reduced his overseas trips since the war and has since the International Criminal Court issued an arrest warrant for him for allegedly illegally deporting children from Ukraine.
More corporate stories. Raslag Corporation discloses it's in talks with a foreign company for possible partnership. The renewable energy developer, though, says discussions with a Hong Kong-based company are still in the preliminary stage. As for the Bank of the Philippine Islands, it has priced its 1.5-year peso fixed-rate bonds due 2025 with an aggregate principal amount of 5 billion pesos with the option to upsize. This is the second tranche under BPI's 100 billion peso bond program and carries an interest rate of 6.42% per annum paid quarterly. BPI says proceeds of that will be used for corporate purposes and to contribute to its funding source diversification. The offer period commences today, Tuesday, until November 3, with the listing set for November 13. President Marcos sets an ambitious environmental goal. He wants half of cars on Philippine roads to be electronic vehicles by 2040. Marcos says this is in line with the Philippines' pledge to cut gas emissions by 75% as part of its agreement with the United Nations. He made the pitch at the launch of China's Dongfeng Motors in the country on Monday. Marcos adds government will offer incentives to manufacturers of electric cars in the country to give the EV shift a boost.
In the Philippines, the transportation sector is the largest source of energy-related greenhouse gas emissions. So, if we aim to fulfill our pledge to the Paris Agreement, we need to boost the share of electric vehicles in the total projected vehicle fleet nationwide. The government aims to increase the share of electric vehicles to 10%, or hopefully 50% by 2040.
Philippine investment approvals and registrations hit over 700 billion pesos this year. Job Manan is on the line for details on this story. Hi, Job.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon. At a palace briefing, Trade Undersecretary Seferinos Rodolfo said out of the over 700 billion pesos in investment approvals, 427 billion were foreign investments, 90% of which were from the renewable energy sector and from countries in the European Union, such as Germany. A total of 307 billion pesos, meanwhile, were local investments. The period of monitoring was from January to September up this year, according to the official. Rodolfo said the 734 billion worth of investment approvals is 102% higher from the same period last year when the Board of Investments recorded 362 billion pesos. Meanwhile, data shared to ABS-CBN News by Rodolfo showed the 734 billion investment approvals covering 200 projects were expected to yield nearly 39,000 project employment. The official said Marcos Jr.'s foreign trips and his visitors in the Philippines have a direct impact on the foreign investment portion since many of these came from the countries the president had visited. He also attributed this to the easing of doing business, removing foreign equity restrictions, and the forming of green lanes for big-ticket projects. Let us hear what he has to say.
Meron hong direct linkage dun sa mga presidential visits. Di lang ho tumaas yung investment approvals, mas dumami pa ho yung foreign component of the approvals. In the past, makikita natin, di ba, hindi naman tayo naging darling of EU countries, no, because of some reasons. Di ba? Pero ngayon nakikita natin that when the president has said we're open for business, tsaka nakikita naman nila yung mga policy reforms dito sa Pilipinas, pumapasok po sila.
Stanley, Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual in July said around $88 million or around 4.84 billion pesos worth of investment pledges made during Marcos Jr.'s foreign trips may materialize this year. The president has so far embarked on 16 travels abroad since June last year. He is expected to visit Saudi Arabia for the Association of Southeast Asian Nations Gulf Cooperation Council Summit this week. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update. Job Manahan.